and welcome to the Texas Motor Speedway, and we are getting ready for the Samsung Radio Shack 500 here in, I believe it's Fort Worth, Texas, at the famous Texas Motor Speedway first opened back in 1997. The race winner was Jeff Burton. Yes, I know my history. Okay, now shut up. On the poll today is...
You knew more than I knew, so...
Yep, I bet I probably did. Hello, Seth Cole. Thank you for joining me up here in the booth today. This is should be a fun race.
Should be, definitely. I mean, this is one of the fastest mile and a half. So a lot of people say Atlanta is, but I seem to think Texas is a little bit faster. And usually, to me, too, Texas is a little bit wider, so it brings about for a lot better racing. Texas is... to me, one of my favorite D-shaped mile and a half tracks.
Yep, Daniel Voyles on the pole. The only car to break into the 27-second bracket with a 27.8, I believe. And to the outside, the second-place driver, William Brock, with a 28.1. So he has got a really... Daniel Voyles is a really fast U.S. Army Pontiac Armory. U.S. Army Pontiac here today, don't you think?
Well, I think you're right. The only question I would have, though, is that car seems to be, since he was the only one to be able to have a sub 48 second lap time, my question
sub
is,
48?
Is that car set up only...
You mean sub 28?
Sub 28. I'm sorry. I'm dyslexic. That has nothing to do with it. Question is that car set up for qualifying, or is that car going to be set up for the race? I think he'll be fine if he's out in front in clean air, but if he gets shuffled back in the field, that car might have some difficulty handling, and we might not see the speed out of that race car that we saw in the qualifying session.
That's true. These cars warm up their engines on pit road, Seth, you want to go ahead and give us a rundown of the top 10 in points?
Yeah, it's kind of like a mixed bag of veterans and rookies. Caleb Kilburn, who won 2 weeks ago, I believe it was, at Atlanta, another D-shaped mile and a half, so you got to think he's going to be someone a lot of people will be looking at coming to this race. He has currently a 10-point advantage over a couple of veterans, Jordan Lopez and Sky Commons, right now 12 points back. Again, Matthew Logan, he ended up, of course, picking up the victory last week at Darlington. He
was
16 points back.
It was three weeks ago Atlanta, 2 weeks ago Darlington, last week was Bristol.
Well, I'm sorry. I'm going based off of when I watched a race to this recording of this race. I don't
well,
know.
Well, I also haven't quite uploaded Bristol yet, so it's the only one I haven't uploaded.
All right. So I will not say weeks ago. I will just simply say the race tracks.
Yep.
All right. So Matthew Logan, who won at Darlington, he's 16 points back. Casey Nanico right now, another rookie, 20 points back. Then you got Jose Mills. He's 35 back. Tyler Reed, he's actually been very consistent this season. He's got a win. He's seventh in points. Zachary Fitzwater, I kind of think Zachary Fitzwater could be the dark horse driver here today. He's been up there consistent, hasn't quite found victory lane yet. He's eighth in points, 45 point back. And Cole Baker, that is your top 10. 52 points right now separating the top 10 in the standings.
Yep, and that's about a little bit over a 1-4 race as... We're doing the 2003 point style, so there's no chase. It's all about consistency here for in this season of the last season of the Budweiser All Pro Series, and but the point systems are still the same as it's 1 point per position. So 53 points, it still would be a lot to make up, as our points leader would have to have a couple of bad days.
A lot to make up, but you also look at as far as talking about the fact that this is the 2003 point system, big opportunity for drivers to make up a lot of positions in the standings too, because yeah, there's a 52 point gap from first back to 10th, but you look 7th on down to about 20th separating. So there's a lot of opportunity here today if drivers have a good run, or if drivers have a bad run, that they could either rise or fall quite a number of spots in the standings.
Yep, I would agree to that as they're coming off of turn number 4, this unique Texas Motor Speedway. I tested with these cars. There wasn't too many glitches, especially with pit road like last time. So let's hope that doesn't happen. The green flag is out. We're underway, and boy, did that 01 car get a jump.
He definitely did. And I think maybe he's of the same mentality I was talking about. He wants to keep that car in clean air. He does not want to get shuffled out of the lead.
Absolutely. You got Jack Halleck in the four car right behind him. Carter Friesen down below. William Brock stuck up on the outside lane. And here comes JJ. JJ Roberts. It's actually Jay Jefferson. So it is a JJ. And Matthew Logan also. That 12 car.
JJ, Jose. I don't know. Maybe.
Throwback. Battle for second place.
Darlington winner, Matthew Logan.
Yep, he's taking over third place. You have a battle for second place between Carter Friesen and the four Jack Halleck up here. Halleck on the outside lane, a bit of a run, but the inside lane has just a little bit more of an edge. Wow, here comes that 12 car.
Run there, making a three-man fight for second, and this is definitely typical Texas. You want to drive in deep on the inside line, but that outside line off the corner can get a little bit of a run to be able to make it a battle either down into turn one or turn three.
That's right, and look at this. I'm sure Daniel Voiles is enjoying what he's seeing in the mirrors. We're going to have a three-wide battle here as Adam Flickinger is trying to stick his nose up here as we see Levi McIntyre coming up into the mix. Boy, when they go three wide, it worries me.
Daniel Voiles is enjoying what he's seeing. I think the one thing he's not enjoying is seeing the fact that 12 car is getting closer, because I think he's got one of the fastest cars on the track right now.
Absolutely. Those two cars have caught up to the back bumper. See if he'll be able to keep them off of him. They're going back. Here's our Daytona 500 winner, Jose Mills, running about dead last. In the 14 car, just a couple of cars hanging out back here in the back of the pack. Now Cody Llamas moves into the last spot. As we've seen cars back here like Qualls, Casey, Nanako, Nanako, however you said it before.
I've actually heard two other people pronounce it differently too, so I'm not exactly 100% certain what the correct pronunciation actually is of his name.
We have a change for the lead up ahead. I just noticed on the score chart here up at the front. It looks like Carter Friesen has taken over the lead, and the 01 of Daniel Voiles has fallen back to the third position.
And you can see right there how the 57 and the 12 have been able to kind of gap the 01. Something tells me now that he's back out in front and clean air. The handling's starting to go away on Daniel Voiles' race car.
Seven laps into a run. True, he could have used up his tires, or maybe he's just trying to... Maybe he said, hey, I led a couple of laps. Let me try to back off and start my strategy.
Tell you what, it's been a dogfight from fourth place on back there. A couple of teammates, David Gum and Levi McIntyre, have been mixing it up. Jay Jefferson's in that. Seth Cole.
Who's Seth Cole? Yep. Clean racing. Here's our Daytona 500 pole sitter, Alex Miller, in that 43 car. He's not up here. Kyle Matthews, who's in desperate need of a good run, is up here as well.
We saw that William Brock faded back early on, but now he's recovered, and both of the Richard Petty cars are actually doing pretty well.
That's true.
Still up. About Kyle Matthews. I mean, right now, the season can only get better for him. Dead last in the points.
Yeah, dead last in the points. Not even.
There's nowhere to go but up, Kyle.
Hasn't even broken 100 points yet. And I don't want to jinx us, but look at these cars. They were three wide battling. They've kind of stretched it out a little bit. Kyle Matthews looks for a spot on Levi McIntyre, but they're for the most part just kind of one and two wide now as the one car really gets on the back bumper of that six.
Wow. If your car is able to handle through the center of the corner, we've seen that you can get a really big run. We saw Matthew Logan was able to do that earlier on, and right now you see is under fire as well, as that one car seems to be rolling very well through the center of the corner. This is a momentum track. You want to make sure corner off, you're going to have more momentum than the car in front of you, so you can make those moves on the front and back straightaway.
That's true. Whoa, the nine. Oh, we had a car through the grass there.
He save it.
Oh, they did. Derek Camill and Jonathan Zorlein all but wrecked. Coming off of turn number four.
I'll tell you what, Derek Hamill, he may have a win this season, but he's 41st in points. I don't think I've seen a driver be in more wrong places at the wrong time in the last few weeks.
Oh, I would completely agree. And in my first attempt at recording this by myself this morning, that doesn't exist. He actually had another one of those incidents of wrong place, wrong time. But thank God for restarts and me having to work. look at these cars, though. Really getting it. Now, my question remains, another question remains is this. When will we start seeing pit stops? And will there be any wrecks when these cars try to come down pit road that could possibly trap people? Also, look at Kyle Matthews work his way through the field.
Boy, Kyle Matthews, last time we looked at him, where was he? Sixth? And now he's battling for second. So, yeah, that car all of a sudden has come alive.
It really has. I guess you could say Kyle Matthews' car is set up for the long run. That's for sure.
I guess you could say Kyle Matthews' car is great.
Damn it, I knew you were going to make that reference.
You pitch me a softball, I'm going to hit it out of the park. I'm sorry.
Now the question is, can Kyle Matthews catch Carter Friesen? As we're going to go back and look through the field, here's another driver, season 8.1 champion, Dylan Young, struggling back here deep in the pack. You saw Cole Baker and Charles Sanford up here as well. Phil Parker, Jessica Shelton is mired in the back here. Man, just when your car's not handling, it's hard. Wow, these cars really drive off that corner.
Though is even though some of these drivers might be back here due to either being boxed in, not able to be able to break free of traffic, or having ill handling race cars, as you alluded to, they're all within the same time frame of each other. Nobody has really fallen way back and lost the draft, and nobody up at the front has really pulled away. We're going to have, as you stated, those pit stops coming up. That could be the best opportunity for some of these guys mid-pack towards the rear of the field to make an adjustment and be able to make some charges towards the front like we've seen Matthew Logan be able to do, Carter Friesen, and Kyle Matthews.
Back here in 30th place is our points leader, Caleb Kilburn. Have been struggling a bit, but...
Right now, I wouldn't worry too much at this point in time. He's got a little bit of wiggle room coming into this race with a pretty good gap. So I think right now they're basically just riding, seeing what they've got. I think we'll see him up near the top 10 in the closing stages of this race.
Very possible. Speaking of closing stages, Kyle Matthews really closing in on that 57.
But, we're seeing the contrast between drivers that had their car set up for the short run and drivers that had their car set up for the long run. I'll tell you, another driver's got a long run car, and that's that 10 car back there. First time I've seen him make an appearance up inside the top 10.
That's right. Bobby Frazier in that number 10 car. He's teammate to the car he's about to pass right now, the 01 of Daniel Voyle. So perhaps a longer, perhaps the one went with a long run, another one went with a short run setup.
I'm actually very impressed with Daniel Voyles, too. We saw him kind of fade back after he got passed for the race lead. I thought we were going to see him drop like a rock through the field, but he's been able to remain up inside the top 10, so very impressive as we got a battle for the lead.
Oh, yes, we do, and somebody just came on pit road in a fiery pace. Didn't look like made the commitment cone. I think that was the person who's in the booth
45?
With me right now.
No, it wasn't.
It might have been this number 38 car. But pit stops are beginning as Kyle Matthews takes the lead here. We're definitely going to have to keep an eye. I don't think anybody wrecked, so at least that's good. Let's see, here comes...
If I'm not mistaken, I'm pretty sure this is one of those Texas where if you come down too fast, it is going to bust you for speeding. So I don't know. He might have been speeding down pit road. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think he was because you see right... Oh!
Yep, a little bit of a delayed reaction there, but I only blame Discord for that. 45 car came in and wrecked Kyle Matthews. What's that going to cost a 5 on this pit stop?
I don't know. It didn't look like that much contact. It would have been to the right rear that might flare out that right rear quarter panel and cause a little more drag than he wants. Oh, and we got some contact on pit road there. Seth Cole getting boxed in as the 22 is trying to get into his pit stall.
Tyler Reed, yep. Kyle Matthews looks like he's done with his pit stop, but they're repairing the car. And look at him. That's just costing him positions.
It definitely cost him. So that might have pushed that into the right rear tire or something. They're having to clear that, and boy, that is a tough break for probably one of the fastest cars on the track.
I have no clue at this point who would be. Well, hopefully he could maybe get a caution, not be involved and get a lot of his spots back. But I don't know who would cycle around as the leader, so we're just going to kind of have to wait and see here.
Question.
I don't know.
Five might have been on pit road longer being held because he went over the pit road speed limit when he got hit by the 45.
Speaking of cars on pit lane, the 45 is stuck in pit lane, and so is Daniel Voiles. Perhaps those two have some kind of penalty for not getting on pit road safely, as we have, as this is our race, this is our race leader, the 43 car of Alex Miller.
I think Seth Cole right now is on either the tail end lead lap or lap down. I think he also had to stay in his pit stall for a while.
Tail end.
You were right. I think he came down pit road over the speed limit.
Yep, tail end and is about to be put a lap down. Seth Cole, I'm actually now hearing in my ear from our NNSTA officials, did in fact get a penalty for not making it onto pit road safely.
Yep, usually about a 30-second penalty that these drivers have to serve if they don't meet the speed. I think that's the same thing that busted William Brock. I'm kind of curious about Daniel Voiles. Looked like he came down pit road. Why he was on pit lane longer.
Yeah,
he's definitely changed the landscape up here at the front of the field.
Yep, as the leader is now Alex Miller in that 43 car. Can Richard Petty's car go back to victory lane? The 43 is approaching his teammate, and the question will remain is, will his teammate just kind of let him go? I mean, it looks like the 45 car. Looks like the 45 is kind of up to speed, just not really in the draft, as these cars are about approaching 200. They're not exactly hitting 200, but they're close. 43 car is going to go to the inside, and his teammate's going to give him plenty of room.
Question is, where did this all cycle Kyle Matthews around to? Because we know he was on pit road. I'm assuming it was to repair damage.
He is 39th, last car on the lead lap.
Yeah, that really killed him. He's hoping and praying for a caution, but even then, I mean, we're at the halfway point, so there is time if he were able to get a yellow to maybe work his way back up to the front of the field, but that's an omen's task.
Yeah. Just one bad pit stop, man. I can kind of blame the pit road here, but then again, even in real life, this is a very tight pit road.
Yeah, you're right. It definitely is a tight pit road, and it's so difficult, too. Like I said, this is one of your fastest mile-and-a-half tracks, and to try and back it down, I'm pretty sure the pit road speed here is like 45 miles per hour. I mean, imagine trying to slow down a 180-plus fast race car down to 45 miles per hour. And these drivers, too, they don't want to give up anything coming to pit lane. You want to have as quick an entry to pit road as you can, because that could be the difference between you picking up two or three spots on track.
Yep, that's very true. Here's a guy I want to shout out. Daniel Price, rookie, started on the last row, and here he is now in the sixth position as he's trying to pass Carter Friesen.
What did I say? Drivers mid-pack near the rear of the field, don't count them out. Just one adjustment might be all it takes for them to be able to work their way up into the top 10. Case in point, right there, you see Price working his way. I think right now he is trying to pass Carter Friesen.
Yep.
Friesen, I'm actually surprised, has faded back a bit there, too, because he had one of the stronger cars on the early run before the pit stops.
Well, again, crowded pit road could cause you to lose some ground, lose some spots.
Now, here's an interesting thing. These drivers all hit pit road, halfway point. If this race goes green to the end, if that's as far as they could go, we're going to see them on pit road again in the final 10 laps.
Oh, that should make things very interesting as we have a change for second place. Matthew Logan in that number 12 takes second place away from the 10 of Bobby Frazier.
We already saw pit road kind of bust Kyle Matthews, who was the race leader at the time. Could pit road, when and if that second round of pit stops take place, bust a driver that could potentially be our favorite to win this race?
It's very much possible. Completed lap 30 of 51. There is about 22 laps to go here in this race. And, boy, I can't wait to see how this is going to cycle around. Kyle Matthews mired back in the 38th position. Daniel Voiles is dead last, a couple of laps down, and stuck for a pole sitter. Cole Baker, Dylan Young back here. Our points leader still in 30th place. So it seems to me like almost everybody except for the leader and maybe a couple of others kind of just retained their positions after cycling around.
Yeah, I think that you're absolutely right about that. There are a couple of drivers I can see that were up towards the front that have kind of faded back a bit. Carter Friesen lost a couple of spots on pit road. Pretty sure that the 29 picked up some spots.
Oh, yeah, he did, because here he is
in the zero.
Here he is in fourth position, Zachary Fitzwater. Driving in that number, driving at 29.
Around the top 15. Losing and gaining positions. I'll tell you right now, though, the one driver I would not want to be, and that's kind of ironic, I would not want to be the race leader, the 43 right now, because he's the one that's using up the most fuel being out in that clean air, so he would probably be one of the first drivers to have to hit pit road when that second round of pit stops take place.
Well, you say that right as the 12th car, Matthew Logan, passed him for the race lead down the front straightaway, and boy, I'm telling you, man, that 12th car is fast.
He was fast early on, too. You're right. We saw him being able to run down the top two and made himself a force to be reckoned with up there in the battle for the lead. We went green, and now after the pit stops, that car again showing that it's kind of a long run setup. And bear in mind, too, races this season, six different winners. Logan would love to be the first repeat winner on the year.
Yeah, he definitely would. And with the All-Star race looming, he's definitely going to be a favorite. Seth Cole, not for position, but is here up, still up here battling to get himself back onto the lead lap. So should a caution come out?
The opportunity, but a caution comes out, slim to none with how the field is spread out. But you still, just in case, want to have yourself in position that if that yellow does come out, that you're going to be able to cycle around on the back, on the tail end of the lead lap. So I think you will see Seth Cole when he gets up here. If he gets up here to the 12, he's going to be fighting him pretty hard.
He's got a good handling race car, Seth Cole does. Just a really bad and unfortunate pit road penalty is what sidelined him right now. Think of the rookies that we have up here, the two, the 12 and the 10. Then we have veteran Alex Miller, who does have a win in the Budweiser All-Pro Series last year coming at Kansas. And as you can see, the 10 car going to throw go to the inside of the 38. Then we have Jonathan Zorlein, who had two wins last season at Texas World and at the second Auto Club race. Bunch of different winners up here, except for the only car up here that doesn't have a win in his career is that 10 car.
You mentioned about Jonathan Zorlein. He just moved into the fourth position, so a factor in the finish of this race. And Zachary Fitzwater right there, I said at the top of the program that I kind of think he's been one of those lane in the weeds drivers. He's had very consistent runs to start off the season. Now I think he wants to find victory lane. He's up there in the top five.
This is a program.
This is a program.
Here comes pit stops.
This is awfully early too. These are short pitters here. Fuel window is open for them to be able to make it the rest of the way if they pit now, but
it's definitely short pitters.
We got them pitting this early.
Yeah, it's definitely short pitters. Definitely right. Here comes the 88 and 24. But Jonathan Zorlein is going to take the lead now. Let's see if he comes in this time.
Only thing I can think of why they would pit this soon is they can have fresher rubber earlier. But I don't know.
Oh, Levi McIntyre stays out this time. Oops. All right, come on. Levi McIntyre stays out this time. Now, the later you stay out, the less time you can spend on pit road because that's less fuel you have to put in your car.
Well, the other thing I would think, too, is the longer you stay out, the more likely it's going to be you're going to come down a rather vacant pit road. I mean, we saw how drivers were busted for pit road speeding penalties. Drivers were getting boxed into their stalls. Contact was being made. Pit road, you got a better chance of a clean pit stop.
All right, let's see what the A car of Cole Deaver does as these cars come down pit road this time.
I'm assuming they're going to go for forked tires. I don't know if you'd necessarily go with just right size because you got to get that car full of fuel, so you might as well take 4 good years anyway.
You never know. Like you said, they came in about halfway, so these cars can go 20 laps on fuel, give or take. But they're just short pitting because they want a shot at being able to, you know, they want a shot at being able to make it to the end. How about DEI up here running, you know, at the time for a second? Levi comes off of pit road. And there goes the 10 on by. The 10, the 12, and the 25. So I believe these two are gonna cycle around as the leaders right here for this final 10 lap run.
43 was the race leader when the pit stops began, though.
Yep, but he's nowhere to be found. Oh, he's in.
Yeah, where'd the 43 go?
He's right here. Look at Carson Gum up here. He just got passed. Could Carson possibly have a fast car? He's up in fourth place. Does he have enough time to catch these two leaders? Excuse me, three leaders who are now battling side by side.
Well, he's 2 seconds back. We'll have to check the telemetry to see. Definitely this right here is going to help him, this side-by-side battle for
second place
between Zorlin and Logan.
Yep, 25 car. Second takes the second position now. The 10 car is going to go right
kind of come up here after like the midway point. I think he might have one of the faster cars right now.
Look at the run he's got. Did you see that? Look at how much. Look at him. He's going to try to go the outside, maybe.
I think the 10 got held up by his teammate Voiles a little bit, and that was also what allowed Zorlin to be able to get such a big run.
Wow, that was a lot of respect Zorlin showed for that 10 car. He got right up to his back bumper. Oh, look at him dive to the inside now. There he goes. Zorlin going to go for the lead in the final 10 laps. This is really going to help that 19 car.
Would Carson Gunn be able to close in? He was about 2 seconds back, 2 laps ago. He's cut it down by 4/10. He's now just a little over a second and a half back. So Carson Gunn is closing.
Catching the 0-1 car is going to be able to go right underneath him.
I tell you, Carson Gunn would love to be able to win here. Carson Gunn, a Texas native, would love to win at his home track.
Jay Jefferson, we saw on pit road. I think he had to serve a black flag penalty. Not sure what yet, but he was there on pit road.
How about that zero there of Price? He's in that sixth position, and don't count him out. I mean, he's only 7 seconds back. He could close in. Oh, Voiles is coming back to pit road. I think actually Voiles is actually making a scheduled stop. Remember, he had to sit on pit road a little bit while on that last round of pit stops, so he probably was able to go a little bit further than these guys.
I'm sure some of those cars were hoping he would have done it earlier.
Yeah, probably.
So now the question does anybody have anything for the 25? We're approaching 5 to go, coming to 6 to go at the line. 6 laps to go.
To be able to close in as far as lap times, I would say the 3 fastest cars on track right now would probably be the 25, the 19, and the 0. But
if we're looking at the fastest lap, you're completely wrong.
I'm talking about right now.
Whoa, that 20 car. Earlier. Yep. 20 car kind of getting in the way. I don't think the 25 car really liked that, but now he's going to be in the way and hold up these cars behind him. 4 laps of racing to go, and the 12 car really had to back off, possibly just gave a shot to that 20 car.
I think he might have at least gotten the air off the rear of that 20 to send him up the hill, no doubt about it.
But the 20 car got the better run off the corner. He's got the fresher tires.
Yep, he does. You're right. Whether it was a scheduled stop or having to serve a penalty or whatever, fresher tires. Now, here's the thing that Matthew Logan's hoping. Yeah, he can't pass the 20, but maybe the 20 can be faster than the 25, get up there and battle with the race leader Zorlin, close back in.
The outside line.
Time's running out, though.
The outside lane is starting to get the better advantage, at least in turns 1 and 2. I just noticed as the 12 car is able to secure his second spot here. I don't know. Jay Jefferson kind of just holding his line in second. I don't really see him coming up there. How interesting would it be for this Hendrick Motorsports number 25 to go to victory lane here today? Remember, last season, Jonathan Zorlein was technically at a Hendrick car, in the 88 car, and here he is still in a Hendrick-related car, and as you see, the 20 car goes beneath him. Here comes the 12 car in a hurry.
That's going to definitely open the door. I mean, remember, these drivers all came to pit road kind of short-pitted, as we documented, so these tires are not going to be at 100% as far as grip. You get kicked up to that outside line, you're not going to find nearly as much grip as you did earlier on, and whoever's able to hold the bottom, I think, is going to be able to find the faster way around the racetrack.
Definitely. We'll see. Two laps to go. Can the 12 car get his second career win in just three races? Coming off of...
With just two laps to go. I'm not seeing Carson Gum closing up quickly enough, so I think it's going to be between the 25, 12, and 10. It's just down to who makes a mistake on this last lap.
White flag, one to go as they head off in the turn number one. The 12 car trying everything he can to get a good run off the corner to set himself up for turn three. Don't know if he can get there.
The bottom line.
Heading off into turn number three, the 25 running the middle lane, leaving a groove open, but it's not really going to matter. Off of turn number four, Jonathan Zorlein, first win of the season as he wins here at Texas.
And how ironic. We didn't really even talk about Zorlein until just past halfway when we saw him making, I think it was a move for fourth place on Zachary Fitzwater. And then, round of pit stops, he was the car to beat.
Yep. Kyle Matthews, unfortunately, will come home with a fast race car, but relegated to 35th as he crosses the line. Poor Kyle Matthews. We're going to go watch Zorlein burn it down and go to victory lane, and then we're going to get the results. Zorlein out here on the front straightaway, ready to celebrate his win. And there he goes.
I don't know, I think he's done this a time or two.
Probably. Now 25 car gets his third career victory, and it comes here at the Texas Motor Speedway. He's excited. I mean, this could put him as a threat for the All-Star race because we're going to a very similar racetrack.
Absolutely. No doubt about it. Same kind of configuration in a way. D-shaped mile and a half.
Zorlein now beginning his trek down over to victory lane here at the Texas Motor Speedway.
Again, as you mentioned, no chase format. So, yeah, this is a big win for him, but it's not going to be his last. He needs more consistent finishes to get himself up there in the top 10. This is one good step towards it.
Yep.
He's a lot more, and he just killed the grass.
He's in victory lane now, going to celebrate with his team. Let's go get the results. Carson, you're going to victory lane, buddy. No, I'm just kidding.
Woo, great job, buddy.
Sorry, we were actually just talking about you during that commercial break. But Jonathan Zorlein.
All good
actually,
things, don't worry, all good things.
Yep, we were just talking about how you actually beat David Gum this time. Jonathan Zorlein in victory lane, celebrating with his crew. I think that's actually his third career win overall and his first of the season. So even though he
was a better time for him either, because he was 24th in points coming to this race. So this will definitely help him jump up a little bit higher on the standings board.
Yep, and with no chase, consistent finishes are going to be all but important. Where did our points leader finish? 27th. Caleb Kilburn finishes 27th. So he may drop a couple of spots here, but a lot of the good guys who were up in the top 10 were also finished bad. Like Casey Nanako back here, Cole Baker, and others back here.
Jose Mills back in 28th. Sky Commons, we didn't talk really about him. He finished 20th. Not a bad run, but not that great.
Yeah. Well, and honestly, so it could be a good points day for some, bad points day for the others. But this race here at Texas Motor Speedway is finally done and over with next week. Oh, crap. Where are we going next week? I don't remember. I think it's either going to be a short track or we're going to Talladega. One of the two. I don't think it's a short...
Well, same difference. Talladega's a short track, so...
I mean, I don't think it's... Because in real life, it was Martinsville, and I don't have Martinsville in the schedule, so I think we just skipped over that and are going to Talladega.
We're going to Texas again, folks.
It's very possible we're going to Talladega. Don't quote me. Like I said before, we're probably going somewhere completely different. For all I know, we could be going to freaking Auto Club. I don't even remember what's next. But anyways,
going to Thornton, the turn of death.
Yeah, everyone's gonna die off the turn of death. Okay, anyways, so thank you guys so much for watching. Seth Cole, thank you for joining me. Hoping to have you up here again at some point in the future, even though it actually is the future. But thank you guys so much for joining me here. This race has been fun. A race has been brought to you by the NNSRA Offline Racing at its best, saying, until we meet again.
Just in, Kyle Matthews finishing 35th, it's now 43rd in points.
Yep.